Hey guys, thank you for watching Cold Blood Creations here on YouTube. If you walk into a pet store or a reptile expo and you're wanting to set up a cage for a bearded dragon and you see all of the choices like these behind me when it comes to bearded dragon lighting, you're probably somewhat confused, maybe even intimidated by all the different products and all the choices. In this video, we're going to break down everything that has to do with the lighting of bearded dragons. We hope by the end of this video, we'll erase some of the confusion and shine some light on what you need for reptile lighting. So in order to keep things real simple and not create a lot of confusion, we're going to break down the bearded dragon lighting into three categories. In category number one, we're going to talk about basking lights. In category number two, we're going to talk about UVB lights. And then in the third and final category, we're going to talk about nighttime lighting, also known as nighttime heat. In this video for demonstration, we're using this cage. Now, I'll be honest with you, this is probably not my favorite type of cage. They do make a lot nicer cages where they have the screen top, but you access the cage through doors on the front. But since I didn't have one of those cages, we're going to go ahead and do this video with what we do have, and that is this, where the door is actually the screen top. The disadvantage to this type of terrarium is that every time you open the terrarium to access your bearded dragon, you're going to have to take your light fixtures off the top of the cage. So be careful that those lights have a chance to cool down before you set them on the floor, especially if you have something like carpet. You don't want to mess around and catch a fire because of a hot bulb setting on a flammable surface. If you can, go ahead and get the type of terrarium that has the stationary screen top and the doors are on the front. That way you don't have to move your lights every time you open your cage. Now, when it comes to basking lights, you're going to need a fixture for those lights. And basically, there are two different types of fixtures that we recommend. One of those is just basically a light fixture like this. Now, you can buy these at any pet store. You can buy the ZooMed or the Exoterra brands. You could also go to a home improvement store like Home Depot or Lowe's and pick up one of these. There's nothing fancy about them. Basically, you want to avoid the cheap ones that have the plastic place right here. Make sure you get one that's porcelain. These things are a lot less likely to present problems. Go ahead and make sure you get yourself a good quality one. Now, the other option that you can have is these double ones right here. Like this particular one here is made by ZooMed, and this is a double fixture. Basically the same as this, except that you have two different cords and two different places to put the lights. Now, we're gonna talk a little bit more about this fixture right here coming up in our UVB part. But as for right now, basically what you would wanna do is to use one of these spaces for your basking bulb. And it doesn't really matter which one of these you use. Now, speaking of basking lights, there are so many different options of basking lights out there. You're gonna see basically the ZooMed and the Exoterra brands. This is 150 watt, this is 100 watt. People asked all the time, how many watts do I need? And that's kinda gonna be subjective. What you're wanting to shoot for is a basking spot that's gonna get up around 100 degrees in temperature. So let's say your room temperature in your home is 75 degrees, you're probably never gonna need 100 or 150 watts. But if your room temperature drops down to like 60 degrees, you're probably gonna need a higher intensity light bulb. However, if your home is kept, you know, warmer, you can drop the wattage of bulbs. Basically, the watt of bulbs you're gonna need is gonna be whatever watt it takes to get your basking spot up to the appropriate temperature. Now, here in our facility, right now, it is 77 degrees with a 41% humidity. At 77 degrees, we would never use this high-powered basking lights of 150 watts or 100 watts unless we were trying to heat up a very, very large cage. Now, I'll tell you a little secret out there. You do not have to buy the nice little fancy bulbs that has the picture of the reptile on the front of the bulb. If you want to save yourself a little bit of money, just a standard incandescent light bulb that comes in a plain package without a pretty picture of a bearded dragon on it will serve the same exact purpose. An incandescent bulb, not an LED, but an incandescent bulb screwed into one of these is just as good and oftentimes a lot cheaper than the bulbs that are produced that has the picture of the bearded dragon on the box. Just because it has a dragon on the box doesn't necessarily mean that this is the only bulb you can use for a dragon. In fact, in our facility, we use nothing but incandescent light bulbs. They're a lot less expensive and they work just as well. Now, your basking light is gonna be where your dragon is able to thermoregulate their body temperature. That's what it's for primarily. Although it will light up the cage, primarily it's used so that your dragon can get warmer or move away from the light and get cooler. And for that reason, we wanna talk about placement. One of the things that we like to do is put the highest decoration in our cage to one side or the other and not put it right in the center of the cage. Also with our basking light, what we like to do is the placement of your basking light to be right above the highest piece of cage furniture in your cage. Now the reason for this is simply this. As your bearded dragon wakes up in the morning and his body temperature is a little cooler, he can come up to this platform and go up closer to the basking light. Once his body temperature is optimal, he can climb back down and move over to the cooler side of the cage. That way you don't have to be spot on with your temperatures, but rather you can allow your bearded dragon to move in and out of the basking area as he sees fit. The next light we're gonna talk about is UVB. We're gonna talk about two different types of UVB lighting. One of those is this tube light right here, available on our website, and it's going to use a bulb similar to this right here. This is what we call tube style UVB lights. Basically what this is going to do is going to produce UVB so that your dragon's body produces vitamin D3 and that's necessary for calcium. The other way to produce UVB is with a UVB bulb like this one right here. This is called a compact UVB bulb. Now, the difference between these two, obviously, is the amount of space they're gonna take up. With this bulb right here, you're gonna need kind of a longer light fixture, such as this one right here. Now, this is a 36-inch cage. This right here is a 36-inch light fixture, and this is a 34-inch bulb. Basically, what you're gonna do, if you decide that you want to use this, is to place your bulb inside your fixture like so. You're going to put this anywhere on the cage. Now, it really doesn't matter if you put it in the back of the cage, if you put it in the front of the cage, or if you put it in the middle. However, if you use a big fixture like this for a basking bulb, you're probably not gonna be able to run it right down the middle. So you're gonna have to decide you want it in the back or if you want it in the front. One advantage to using this long style UVB light is that it actually lights up very beautifully the entire cage. The disadvantage to it is that most of the time your bearded dragon's probably gonna be pretty far away from the light. And the closer they are to the bulb, the more benefits they're gonna get from the UVB. Now, the other style UVB light that we're gonna talk about is this little compact one right here. Now, we also have these available on our website. This is the Arcadia brand. This is a very good quality brand of UVB light. And they screw into a standard fixture like this. Now, one neat thing about the double fixtures like these right here is that you can screw in your UVB bulb into one side, you can screw your basking bulb into one side, you can place this over the basking light, and you're gonna get UVB and the basking temperatures all in one isolated location of your cage. Now, the disadvantage to doing it that way is that you're not going to fully light up the entire cage. However, if you're using a 40-gallon tank, there's gonna be sufficient light in there. Now, if you're lighting up a big cage, you probably wanna go with the tube-style lighting. Let's talk a little bit about how long to leave these lights on. I like to leave the Bearded Dragon's basking and UVB lights on throughout the entire daylight period of the day. Now, we set up timers for our bars. They come on just a few minutes after the sun comes up in our location, and then we have a timer that cuts them off a few minutes before the sun goes down, and we have to adjust our timers throughout the year. You do not want to leave lights on 24 hours a day. Your basking light and your UVB light should go out at night to give your dragon a dark period of time in which he can sleep without having the intensity or the heat of that light. Imagine sleeping in your bedroom with your lights on all night long. That's kind of what you're going to subject your dragon to if you don't turn the basking and the UVB lights off at night. For a quick review, you're going to need one basking light. It can be one of these brands, or it can be a regular incandescent. It can be in a double fixture, or it can be in a single fixture. You're going to need a second light, which is going to be your UVB. That can be the long tube style like this that runs the length of the cage. Or if you want to use a double fixture, you can use this type of UVB light right here, right beside your incandescent bulb. So that brings us to our third and final category, and that being nighttime lighting. The use of a nighttime heating source is going to be dependent on the temperature that your cage drops to at night. You're probably going to want to get yourself a digital thermometer, hydrometer, such as this one right here. What you want to do is watch your cage during the nighttime. Does the bearded dragon's cage drop down below 70 degrees at night? Now, one interesting fact about reptiles is that they heat up very quickly, but they cool off very slowly. And we can utilize that fact to our advantage in that if the bearded dragon has ample room to bask, his body temperature can go up very much during the daytime, and your cage drops down to 70 degrees at night, you probably don't even need to use any type of supplemental heat at night. However, if you live up in, say, the Northeast somewhere where it gets really cold, your temperature in your home drops down really cold at night, if you look at this thing early in the morning and it's reading that your cage temperature is dropping down to 65 degrees or somewhere in there, or even colder, then yes, you're probably gonna need to use some type of nighttime supplemental heat. Now, there's a couple of different options. There's obviously the red bulbs that the pet stores sell. That's one option. I personally don't like the red bulbs for dragons because they do actually produce some visible lighting. There's a little bit of argument about whether bearded dragons can see red light or not. I say, why even risk it? If I was gonna use one of those bulbs, I would probably go with something like this nighttime black bulb. These things don't produce any visible light. It's easy to tell when they're on because there'll be just a little bit of blue color, a purple coloration to the bulb. You can tell when it's on. Even better of an option than that is what we call a ceramic heater. This right here is a ceramic heat emitter, and we also carried these on our website. We actually carried these in two different wattages. You can get a 60 watt and you can also get 100 watt. It looks like this right here. Now, this will screw into the same type of light fixture like this. So if you're using a nighttime heating light, you're gonna need another fixture just for this, or else you're gonna have to end up taking your daytime bulb out and putting your nighttime bulb in. And remembering to do that every day can be somewhat of an inconvenience. So I would highly advise you to have your lights for the daytime, set them on a timer to come on 12 hours or so during the day, and then if need be, have your ceramic heat emitter come on at night. The one advantage to this over the black bulb or even the red bulb is that these things tend to last a very, very long time. I will caution you though, make sure that you buy a good quality brand. Some of these things that you buy on Amazon, we have gotten before. They're very cheaply made, and you don't want to create a fire hazard in your home, especially at night while you're in bed asleep. For clarity's sake, if you're using a double fixture like this, you've got your basking bulb and your UVB bulb. This light's going to be placed over your basking area. and that's gonna be for your basking UVB. If you need nighttime supplemental lighting, the placement of that light is not as important, seeing as your dragon's not gonna be basking at night. Basically, the supplemental nighttime heat is just gonna be able to keep the ambient temperature throughout the cage a little higher than it would be without the nighttime heating. Once again, our general rule is if the cage doesn't drop below 70 degrees, we don't even worry about nighttime heating or nighttime lighting. It's simply not necessary as long as your dragon's not getting too cool. Hopefully this has cleared up some things. If there's still something that you have a question about, leave us a comment down in the comment section below. Otherwise, thanks for watching. Have a great evening or morning, wherever you're at. Especially if that surface is flammable, you don't want to mess around and get yourself caught on fire, because that don't make sense, does it?